Good afternoon from Greece, Skinakas Observatory in the island of Crete. We are happy to participate to the 100 Hours of Astronomy. My name is Yannis Papamastorakis. My colleague Andreas Zezas is also professor at the University of Crete. We are giving you some explanation what the university here and the Skinakis Observatory are doing concerning research and education of the students, not only in Greece, but through the web in every country of this globe. So Skinakis Observatory is on island of Crete on 1,750 meters altitude. You can see an approach to the island of Crete from the south, you can see that the observatory located in Skinakas, a mountain in the middle of Crete, has a free site to the north-northwest from where the prevailing winds are blowing. This is an aerial photograph of the observatory with various buildings and telescopes. We'll show after what they are. This is the white colored building with 1.3 meter Ritchie Chretien telescope. The other one houses the 60 centimeter robotic telescope in collaboration with the University of Tübingen in Germany. One of the most promising things about Skinakas is the excellent astronomical seeing. Of course, a telescope on the moon will have no problems with atmospheric seeing, but on the Earth, the atmospheric seeing, the turbulence in the atmosphere, creates much larger images and reduces very strong the ability to telescope to see two different stars if they are very close one to the other. And very, very excellent seeing like Skinakas one is very promising in observing, say, double stars or to see details in a sky object. The Skinakas one 3-point meter telescope is a Ritchie Chretien design and has a lot of very modern instrumentation like a near-infrared camera and high-resolution time-resolution photometer, many CCD cameras, spectrographs, and so on. The 60-centimeter telescope is a robotic one, can be used from everywhere through the internet, and creates has created very, very nice images, pictures of the sky, of sky objects, and also scientific observations. We have also a small telescope, but has a very wide field, more than 3 degrees, and this makes possible to image very extended sources. We have made a lot of observations of extended galaxies and planetary nebulae and supernova remnants as examples. Here are some examples of our observations. You see comet Hale-Bopp with a very nice tail. A supernova remnant named CDB1. A globular cluster, NGC 60426. We use these globular clusters to calculate the age of these old, very old objects and set a limit on the age of our galaxy and of the universe. This globular cluster is one of the oldest and metal purest in our galaxy. We also make scientific observations of galaxies, spiral galaxies, which are seen edge-on, and comparing the observations with models, we have found out what the properties of dust in other galaxies are. In order to make these observations, we have developed the possibility of remote...
I'm sorry to interrupt you. I have to ask you guys to wrap up, if you could, in the next 30 to 60 seconds. The Around the World in 80 Telescopes is getting ready to start in just a second. So if you guys could... I'm sorry to rush you, but if you could wrap up, that would be great. Thanks.
Okay. So there are a number of projects for university students. They are will be presented by my colleague Andreas.
Hello. This is we are a member of the COSMOS project, which is a consortium of European universities that has organized and has produced some educational material on the internet. So students from various universities all around the world can access them and learn about astronomical techniques and how to measure the properties of astrophysical objects. I'll present you briefly some of those examples. So, for example, you can learn how to analyze CCD images from telescopes. You can learn how to measure colors of astronomical objects and their physical meaning. We can measure and the cores and tidal radius of global clusters. Or we can estimate the extinction, electron density, and temperature of planetary nebulae. We can classify elliptical galaxies and measure their radial light distribution based on images that we observe from the Kinakas Observatory, for example. Or we can classify stars based on their stellar spectra.
There is also a great interest.
I'm sorry to interrupt you. I'm sorry to cut you off again. I think this is as long over time as we're allowed to go. Thank you guys so much. Thanks to all of our presenters who came before. I'm sorry that we didn't have time to get to your questions. Thanks to Magpie, to Internet2, and to Storm Center for technical support. If you still have questions there you'd like to learn more, you can visit the websites of all of the science centers and planetariums that presented here today. They should be on your screen right now. And if you'd like to learn more about science centers and what the Association of Science and Technology Centers does, you're welcome to visit us online at www.astc.org, where later we'll have a video replay of this webcast. Thanks so much.